Okay, today we're going to stray off the beaten path with these new side missions, which can be completed once you complete the relevant chapter. First of all, you go to the main menu and select it, because it has the thing. And then you get this little entry, it's the, you know, the exclamation mark. This little speech from Chatot. And you can see our characters there. And it's like, let's do the best we can. And you just see Bidu. And by the way, folks, this is set in the past. So, we're going to look into Bidu's memories and complete them in this special mission. Which is an awesome side feature because it gives you some extra missions in the game and some extra dungeons to explore. So, special episode 1, Bidu's Wish. Okay, so it gives you like this little cutscene bit. And it shows you this beautiful thing. I'm really impressed with these latest new Pokemon technologies. I'm really looking forward to the Heart Gold and Silver ones as well. And there will be a playthrough on that. But there'll be a one before the Heart Gold and Silver. So anyway, it's Bibarel and two Bidoof, which you can probably guess are probably Bidoof's parents or brothers, sisters, whatever. He's like, yes, I'm going to go out and explore. Then Bidoof kind of walks off. And those ones are like, Bidoof, wait. And they're like, ah, oh, goodbye. And they wave him goodbye. Okay, so it gives you more writing. And we're at the guild. And this is before we're here, and it's Loudred who's shouting Bidoof, who's the new recruit. And Bidoof comes running and he's like, what have I done? And Loudred's like, what? And he gets really angry. He's like, what have you done? And then Krogoth's like, oh my god. There's one in the background. But Bidoof is now eating a perfect apple. And then Chatot comes in. He's like, oh, sorry, I'm not meant to eat that. And Chat was like, what? That's Guildmaster loves perfect apples, which I'm sure you'll probably find out more about if there's the apple woods on here. And we're like, oh, and Chat was like, oh my god. And Bidoof's then happy, and he's like, oh my god, I've just filled my face. And Chat was like, what? You're not even apologizing after eating the Guildmaster's perfect apple? And it continues along those lines. Chat hops about a bit. And Chatot's getting really annoyed at the moment. So anyway, hops on down here. More writing. So it's like the next day or later that day, whatever. Comes up with smiles go for miles. And they're like, hooray. As Bidoof's going off, Chatot calls him over. And Chatot's like, oh, you must go into the village and get another perfect apple for the guildmaster. And Chatot's like, oh no. So anyway, Bidoof's pretty upset at the minute, as you can see. I feel sorry for Bidoof, but it's his fault, he shouldn't have eaten the perfect apple. It tells you more, it just tells you, go to the Kecleon shop. So, we're now in control of the Bidoof. So, you try and look at the outlaw boards and he's like, oh, I shouldn't, really shouldn't be doing this, I should be helping out the guild, blah blah blah. So anyway, get up here. Exit the guild through here. Then you can run. So anyway, we come here and Corfish is out there and he's like, oh, I shouldn't really go in here, I should be helping the guild. It's that way. So anyway, let's just have a look at the beach, because I haven't shown you that before in this playthrough. This is where we first met Piplup when we were the Chimchar. He's like, this is the beach cave, which he didn't know this was. So, oh, I shouldn't be doing this. So Obedience's like, come on, I must go. So we're just going to run back on his short little legs. Up here. All the way up here. Okay, so we come to basically here. Electrovire isn't there yet. But it's the Kecleon brothers. So he's like, hello, Bidoof. So anyway, he's like, perfect apples. No. And they just have this really calm conversation, and he's like, searching his stock, and he's like, I don't have any. And they're like, oh, no. That's a shame, Bidoof. And Bidoof's like, oh, I'm disappointed. The Kecleon's like, so anyway, these are getting, well, he's talking about things now, don't know exactly what about, but he thought I should go back to the guild and say to Chatot that it's just not fair. So, 6,500? What? Don't even get a choice of this now, because it wants you to buy. It's like, oh my god, this is the money my pop-up gave me. But we'll see that in a cutscene now. So the dad goes, this is all we have. Bibarel says to Bidoof, this is all we have. You must take it, so you can pursue your dreams as a guild explorer. So it's quite a lot of money in terms of Pokemon games. Can't really earn a lot of money in this dungeon game either. Seems like I shouldn't really, but he's just walking out, and Kecleon Brothers like, wait. And he's like, oh, sorry. So he's walking out, and there's this Snova. It's quite mad. Then just like, oh, so what? Yeah, speaking to the Snova, it's a bit of like, what's happened? And then Bagon and Gligar come up. And they're like, where's Snova? We need to find that Snova. So they're quite mad at the minute. Gligar's getting quite annoyed. And Bagon is too, by the looks of things. So Bidoof then goes back. So, not going to save the adventure just yet. And then Chimecho's, dinner's ready. So you can guess what's happening here. Munch, 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 chew, 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 munch, munch, munch. But our places at the back haven't been filled yet. So, this is Bidoof's sleeping area. We get to see where Loudred and Corphish and Bidoof sleep. There's like a little well area there. They're quite upset by the looks of things. It's like the next morning, Loudred's like, oh, I'm tired. And he's still yawning. He's asleep, or he's talking in his sleep. So Bidoof's, well, sorry for Bidoof. So anyway, Bidoof then goes up and reminisces about Snova. I think Bidoof in a minute is going to try and set out to find Snova. So Bidoof's like, oh, I'm so tired. Should be really getting back to sleep. Then he takes it out and looks at it. Whatever this is. Or the parcel Snova gave him. or map. So then he puts it in and he goes back to sleep. Loudred talking away still. You have to wait for the action next part. This is just the introductory bit, as you have to do. And I suggest you join us next time for these special adventures. Goodbye.